how do you build on that engagement, Sasha, on the content element?
So in terms of content, I think there's quite a few different pieces to that. First of all, you've got to think about curating your content differently. When a client comes to us and says, you know, we do lots of work with, you know, we're about events with purpose. So our events are very much, very often for think tanks, associations, nonprofits. And so that might be an event, you know, that you have every year. And so people sometimes come to us and they go, well, we've got our event. We just want to like put it on Zoom. We just want to put it on the internet. And actually we say to people, let's go back to the beginning. Let's rethink the purpose of the event. Let's work through what the event narrative is and what we're trying to achieve. And let's build that back into a program and content that works for digital. You know, the days of being at an event where somebody speaks, you know, for 45 minutes, I don't know if that's ever happening again, but it certainly is very unlikely to happen on the internet. And actually what's really interesting is that we've all been in those event halls where, you know, somebody gets up to speak and it's a little bit too long and you suddenly see everybody kind of there on their mobile phone because they've lost interest. Now, you know, what you see at the back end of, I mean, we quite often use Hopin, you know, but at the back end of your platform, when you're looking at the analytics, you can see the equivalent of people going on their phones, they're dropping off. So you want to build that engagement with the content. What does that mean? You want to curate it tighter, sharper, shorter, and make sure it's really engaging. You want to have a good proportion of it live, ideally, and we can talk about that a little bit later on. You want people to be able to engage with it in lots of different ways. So whether that's about really great Q&A, and we very often put systems in place where, you know, the teams inside our clients are helping curate those questions and they're going straight to the kind of back of house teams, so that the speakers are getting it immediately. Because what makes the event really real is, you know, exactly what you were doing, Ricardo. You're like, hey, Charlie, how are you? Nice to see you. And I see Charlie's got a really interesting question. That already feels live. Mm-hmm. And that's the difference. And you can have that engagement. One of the things that we see that really is a massive difference from in-person events is the chat. You know, when you signpost your delegates and participants well around the platform and encourage them to engage, you can get phenomenal chat going. So, you know, many platforms have that chat box to the right of the stage. And so if you start off and signpost it well, that can go crazy. I mean, we had one event for a client, which actually, when we downloaded it at the end, it was a one-day event, 50 pages of chat. And that chat was people saying, and this is one of the things which I think is almost better about digital events than in-person events, which is, you know, in fact, one of my clients said this to me about, we did an event in September, which we postponed it from March. It was going to be on March 17th. March the 17th, we were like, you know what? We're not bringing those 180 people together at the RSA because that's how big the RSA is. We did it in September, 1,500 people, because there are no limits to a digital event. And so that was the event with the 50 pages of chat. And what the client said to me, which was so interesting, he said to me, what I love about this, which is better than the in-person event, is that I can actually see the conversation going on in people's head. They're like, this is a really interesting presentation. I just read an article in The Economist about this. And someone else is like, oh yeah, we're doing a research project on this. We're looking for collaborators. And so you can have conversations actually with everybody. In an in-person event, I might sit next to you and have a great chat, but I might not.
Totally. You know? And I think that's kind of where people get too stuck into that same idea. Like, exactly, when you're in a live environment, there is a session about certain topics. How do you know? You can just obviously judge it by looking at people's faces, if they're engaged or not. They're probably thinking about something else. The same thing happens with digital, et cetera. And then I think the key part of bringing that element live is that you remember that you have a chat panel. Remember that you have, yes, you might have your presentation going, but remember that there's also some other stuff going on outside that session and that presentation. And I think that's kind of one of the key things of the way you bring that alive is, again, spark that exciting conversation within the Q&A. It doesn't really matter what's happening while the conversation is happening, right? So that's
one
element.
It's completely fine that it's happening while the conversation.
Yeah. Yeah.
We are all people with continuous partial attention anyway. And so, of course, we have that at digital events. So I think you're completely right. I think that sparking the conversation, but also signposting people around the platform and what's possible.
Okay, you know, tell me about that, because that's the excitement thing, and that's what you guys do very, very well. And I want the audience to understand